30 kilometers into the East China Sea stands one of the most unusual ports on the planet. From the air, it looks like a sprawling industrial city rising from the water, packed with towering cranes, wide concrete yards, and ships the size of skyscrapers gliding toward its piers. But as you draw closer, something feels off. The docks are almost silent. Trucks move without drivers. Cranes swing containers with unbroken precision. Yet there's barely a person in sight. This remote offshore complex now moves so much cargo that a slowdown here can ripple through supply chains from Asia to Europe and the United States. Only after watching its operations unfold does the scale become clear. This is Yangshan Deep-Water Port, one of the busiest and most advanced ports on Earth, moving more than 14 million containers in the first half of 2025. Please take a moment to subscribe and like the video. It really helps the channel. Global trade depends on ports, and nearly 90% of everything shipped around the world travels by sea. But by the early 2000s, traditional harbors were reaching their limits. Ships had grown dramatically, carrying more than 20,000 containers at once, and drawing far deeper drafts than earlier generations. Ports like Los Angeles, Rotterdam, and Singapore pushed their capacity, dredged channels, and expanded terminals, but many still lacked the depth and space required for these giants. Shanghai faced an even tougher problem. It was already one of the most important gateways in China's economy, but the shallow waters around the Yangtze River Delta simply couldn't accommodate the emerging class of megaships. Dredging deeper channels was costly, slow, and ultimately insufficient. Expanding along the shoreline wasn't possible either. Shanghai needed a new solution, one that didn't exist anywhere else in the world at the time. Instead of reshaping the coastline, Chinese engineers asked a more radical question. What if the port didn't need to be on land at all? South of Shanghai lies a rugged group of islands known as the Donghai Islands. Remote, rocky, and largely uninhabited, they offered something the mainland couldn't. Naturally deep water, more than 15 meters in many areas. Building a major port here would be a once-in-a-century gamble. The islands sat exposed to the open sea, vulnerable to typhoons and fierce waves, and constructing anything this large so far offshore posed extraordinary logistical challenges. But if it worked, China would unlock a deep water gateway capable of handling the world's largest ships. The price for making that vision real would exceed $20 billion. Work began in 2002, and the first challenge wasn't constructing the port itself, but figuring out how to reach these islands at scale. Engineers answered with the Donghai Bridge, a 32.5-kilometer span stretching across open water, connecting the mainland directly to the new construction site and becoming one of the longest sea-crossing bridges ever built. With access secured, crews turned to reshaping the islands. Granite hills were blasted apart. Millions of cubic meters of fill were poured into shallow waters to enlarge the landmass. Breakwaters the size of small mountains rose from the sea, shielding the new port from the violent storms that sweep across the East China Sea each year. The project advanced through four major phases, each one adding more berths, more equipment, and more operational capacity. What began as a cluster of rocky islands slowly transformed into one of the most ambitious engineering sites in modern history. Each stage pushed further offshore, expanding the complex into a full deep water network capable of handling vessels too large for most ports around the world. By 2017, Yangshan's growing capacity helped lift Shanghai to a new global ranking. The city became the busiest port on Earth, surpassing long-dominant hubs and setting a new benchmark for maritime logistics. China's national figures reveal the full scale. Between January and April 2025, ports across the country handled more than 112 million containers, a volume unmatched by any other economy. Yangshan itself is still expanding. The next chapter focuses on Xiaoyangshan Island, where a massive extension is now underway. This new area will add more than 11 million TEU of capacity, accommodate vessels up to roughly 70,000 deadweight tons, stretch the port's shoreline by 6 kilometers, and require more than 100 million cubic meters of additional reclaimed land. The first section is scheduled to open in 2026, setting the stage for yet another leap in global rankings. Stepping into Yangshan today feels like entering the future of port operations. The traditional noise and chaos of a busy harbor are gone. The docks operate with quiet precision. There are no crane drivers perched above the quay. Instead, operators work from remote control rooms, guiding the giant arms that lift containers on and off ships with remarkable accuracy. Driverless vehicles glide across the vast yards, following digital pathways mapped by GPS and onboard sensors. They carry containers to automated stacking cranes that sort and organize them using data-driven systems that know exactly where every box is stored and when it will move again. The entire facility runs on a digital backbone that tracks each container in real time. Ship arrivals, storage plans, and departure schedules adjust continuously through AI-supported platforms. Cleaner, low-sulfur bunker fuel continues to be adopted across terminals, pushing the port closer to its long-term environmental goals. The result is a system that runs faster, safer, and with a fraction of the human labor required at traditional ports. The shift to automation transformed the workforce. 2 decades ago, Yangshan would have been filled with drivers, signalers, and dock workers guiding ships and cargo by hand. Today, those roles have almost disappeared. But rather than eliminating jobs entirely, the port reshaped them. Thousands of workers were retrained in new skills, becoming IT technicians, control room supervisors, robotics maintenance staff, and data analysts. Operations became safer and cleaner. Injuries fell. Heavy lifting and hazardous tasks moved entirely to machines. Yet the transition wasn't easy. Older workers faced steep learning curves, and some struggled to adapt to roles centered on software and autonomous systems. Yangshan became a real-world example of how automation changes not just industries, but people's lives. Yangshan plays a pivotal role in China's wider strategy for global trade. As a major hub within the Belt and Road Initiative, it strengthens routes linking Asia with Europe, Africa, and beyond. In 2025, it formed a new green and digital shipping corridor with Barcelona, aligning both ports on cleaner fuels and advanced data-driven operations. Its economic reach, however, also intersects with geopolitics. In 2025, fuel supply operations linked to Yangshan came under increased international scrutiny, contributing to short-term volatility in China's marine fuel futures. The episode highlighted how an offshore port built to solve an engineering challenge has grown into a strategic asset with global consequences. Even with its success, Yangshan carries real vulnerabilities. Building such a massive complex in open water altered marine environments and sparked long-term ecological concerns. Heavy reliance on digital systems means a major cyber attack or breakdown could disrupt operations instantly. And its offshore location exposes it to typhoons and rising sea levels, requiring constant upgrades to keep the port secure. Yangshan is becoming the blueprint for future ports. Offshore, automated, low emission, and built for ships that continue to grow in size. But its construction required political will, deep water geography, and enormous financial backing that few countries can replicate. The question now is whether this becomes the global model or remains something only China could build. From a chain of isolated granite islands to a deep water terminal moving millions of containers each month, Yangshan has reshaped global trade in less than 2 decades. Its automation, scale, and offshore design set a new benchmark for what ports can be, and for how future megaprojects might break free from geographical limits. This is how China built one of the most ambitious offshore ports the world has ever seen.